Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory. We are continuing with our rusty cap challenge. And I wanted to do this brief little clinic on rust application or rust-based coat color application and show you a few little things along the way, both using brushes and using a piece of sponge. But also give you a contrast later when we come back and we start working with the airbrush. Now, one of the things that I wanted to talk a little bit about was, of course, paint and color selection. After you primer your cap and you you add your primer as a foundation, and remember that in this case we used ruddy brown, we used black, and we used a little bit of gray here and there. So we've got primer all over the cap, and now what we are going to do is we are going to lay down our real base coat of rust, that later on when we do the salting technique you will see the rust coming through, so on and so forth. So right now there are many ways that you can apply the rust. I prefer the airbrush method, but you know what? Just as easily you could go in this round, and especially with something that you're not worried too much about the scale, you could go with some acrylics right out of the bottle. These are stippling brushes, okay? One is flat and this one is round. And you're gonna see how I'm gonna use those. A little tray for the paint. That's why I keep your lid containers, because you could use them as palettes, and also plastic plates. And when you're choosing your rust colors, you know what? I don't even think of the names anymore or the brands. I have a whole bunch of different brands here. So we basically just go on a palette of dark and rich and bright, all the way to yellows, ochres, you know, and you'll see it. So, you know, remember to shake your paint really well, and you put a little bit, you know, on there. And as I said, you could use, in this case, we're going to start with our stippling brush, you know. And you can see how, you know, I'm basically just dipping it. And what we're going to do, of course, is we are just going to come in and randomly, you know, stipple the paint. And at this point, it doesn't matter. You could, I mean, you could just scatter it everywhere you possibly can. Again, to create variety, to create kind of a variegated, spotted surface. Again, you've seen me do this time and again with the airbrush, but in this case we are using a stipple brush, okay? And don't worry about getting your paints on your fingers and all of that. These are acrylics. The beauty of them is that they, you know, that they'll come off with some hand washing. So, and I mean, and along the way sometimes I just use my fingers. You could also put texture like that, but granted, you know, you don't, obviously you don't want to do this to a model car, but to something like this, it actually adds quite a bit. And so, you know, it's just going on really haphazard, really messy, right? And at this point, like I said, it's not gonna matter how you get it all down, because the idea is to get a variety. Then, you know, same thing, you could use a sponge, a little piece of sponge, and you can come in and just sponge the color, you know, and it, you know, where, and of course this is a very bright red, it's actually orange oxide, you know. And the idea, of course, is to stipple it, to speckle it, to make the surface look completely different. The beauty of acrylic, of course, is that it dries fairly fast. If you want it to dry even faster, you do it with a hair dryer. You know, in this case, it's so hot in here right now that the paint is drying very quickly. Okay, and it's fairly thin paint, you know. Of course, I'm using Game Color by Vallejo. I'm using Model Air by Vallejo. I'm using Tamiya Com Colors, Comart Colors. I'll get it right. Comart Colors. Yeah. And I'm trying to get, you know, and again, you want to just get the color spotted. And so you apply, let me apply now a, this one is yellow ochre. There we go. At this point, we want to create a little bit of a contrast between light and dark, you know, so very, and there's really, this is what, why so many people are doing this, because there's really no wrong way of doing it. You know, you just, look at that, see? The idea is you just bring the color in, okay? You bring the color in, you stipple it here and there. Now, this is a stage where if you didn't know any better, you'd start to think, oh my goodness, I've ruined it. What was I thinking? This is crazy, all of that. But trust me, you haven't ruined it. There's really no way of ruining it. You're just adding variety of color, okay? You're speckling it on here, and you're gonna see that when we start working with the salt, you know, it'll all even out. It'll all start looking really, really good and fairly realistic for the technique, you know.